So you can see, obviously, I put that on quite heavy, but it's, it gives you an idea of the colour. It's matte again, because I really do only want the glitter and the glow and the shimmer where I've specifically put the glitter and the glow and the shimmer. Particularly because if I do do a heavier makeup and not an everyday makeup, or maybe it's say more a nicer lunch or something that I'm going for, I will add shimmer under my eyes. So I do want to kind of limit what I'm using, and every day for me isn't too much glimmer. Glimmer, is that a word? Glitter and shimmer. I think glimmer is a word anyway, but so yeah, about £2. Really cute, really small. Does the job. And I'll be moving to my e.l.f., which is, this is quite a pink one. It's Bashful, it's called. But that is more of a comp. So the last and final thing that I do use on my skin. Say blushes that were just scratchy on my skin, which I didn't mind. So this I put my powder on with. Just dab it into my skin. I do prefer to dab powder in rather than scrub it in, because I feel it kind of stays where I put it. Of my dark eyebrows with the sometimes get. And I love it. It's very soft. It's easily blendable. You can kind of make little hairs with it, like that. I'm not describing this at all very well, but there we go. So I don't know if this has a colour. Oh, it's called Fair, which, you know, that makes them. So yeah, I'm really happy with this. I bet I've had this since the beginning of the year, and it's easily probably that much left, so very happy with that. Dyed down behind the highlighter again, so it can't run off. Oh, it's staying there now. And then last, but very, very not least, is my mascara. So this isn't actually my normal go-to mascara. I normally go for e.l.f. or MUA again, or Revolution I've had before. But I ran out during lockdown, and I ran out almost immediately. I hadn't used it for a few days because I wasn't wearing makeup. And the next time I went to get my old mascara, it was just dry. I don't know if I left the lid off slightly or happened, but it couldn't be used, so I got one quite quickly, which meant I got the choice of what was in my local supermarket, which was, I think, Rimmel, Maybelline and Collection. So I don't use Rimmel or Maybelline because they, I believe, still test on animals in certain countries that they sell to, and Collection don't, so that's why I went for them. They're also the cheapest, and I really like Collection, so it works for me. So this is the Collection Extreme Coloured Lengthening Mascara, and it's just black. I always go for black. I think maybe when I was younger I perhaps had a blue one. I think there was a time when different colour mascaras were in fashion. Maybe they still are, but I've always gone for black. I have very, very light eyelashes, and quite small, they don't stand out very well. So I do want that kind of black, big, standout mascara that other people have, so very naturally. So this is High Shine Vibrant Colour Lengthening Mascara. Bright eyes that pop. And it is almost your box standard wand. Does what it says put in. It's not smudge proof or waterproof, but since using it, I haven't really been anywhere to test it out. You know, I've been working from home, I've been popping to the shop. It hasn't had a test of a full day. Travelling to and from the office, sitting in a hot air conditioned, but moving hot air around rather than cold air in the office. you know, then coming home, walking the dogs, doing all the normal tasks. It's not really had to do much. I should probably stop doing that before it dries out. It hasn't had much of a test, but I would say I like it. It's good so far. And that's that. So you can see actually where my focus is with my makeup. It's very much on my skin. And then just, I suppose, making a little bit more of my eyes, making them stand out a little bit more. I don't really use eyeshadow every day, or false lashes or anything like that. I have really sensitive eyes. I seem to be okay with mascara, but anything more, even eyeliner, I have to be really careful with, because it does make my eyes water, and then you end up with a nice sticky black or brown smudgy mess. I very often have been out on a night out and tried a new eyeliner or eyeshadow out, and something in it's affected my eyes, and half my eyeshadow's either cracked dried off or smudged off. So I tend to go for less is more look with my eyes. So that really is my everyday makeup. The only thing I suppose I haven't shown you is this, which I'm thinking of incorporating into my everyday look, and it's the e.l.f. foundation palette recently. I think this does the job for the moment, but if I'm looking for anything slightly heavier coverage, then I'll be moving to that. I think it's just a really cute little set.